Everyone has what's known as a breaking point. A point where you put up with so much that at any moment, the next drop could more than snap the camel's back. By all professional standards, and by endless documentation, medical, mental, verbal intelligence, and otherwise, I defy most of them. I'm going to support you. As a humanitarian, as a diplomat, as a philanthropist, as a had it. I am formally declaring war on assholes, haters, cripples, careless badges, people who slander to be liable and put up more fake news than a fucking shit machine. Trump, if I were you, I would go hide in the corner. Because if you run for office, guarantee you, I'm gonna release so much shit that you're gonna look like the piece of shit you really are. And that's not a threat. That is a legal motherfucking promise, bitch. Obama, you owe me more than apologies. Kerry, you better rescind the dogs. Even though you're not in office, you know how to do that. And if you don't call me, I'll figure it out for you, bitches. But I'm done with the horseshit. And Biden, I'm not asking anymore. I'm demanding immediate funding from the United States government to offset the damages caused by the United States government to me a disaster relief so I can do a concert for world peace and show you bitches how to get your life straightened out. Because I'm tired of you running into the fucking ground on planet Earth. You disgust me. And Kamala Harris or whatever you want to call your dumbass, you need to stand up for some stuff. There's nothing I can vote for you on right now at this moment, or Biden. In fact, I wouldn't vote for anybody on Capitol right now. I'd say to hell with all of you. You're a lying bunch of pieces of shit. And it's no longer going to be just us for just us who can afford it, assholes. It's going to be just us for everybody across the board. The glass ceiling is going to go away, and you motherfuckers who break the law are going to go down. So, if you want to start making your amends to society, stop the horse shit at Capitol Hill. And let's get together and have a couple of Senate subcommittee hearings and some House hearings. Because otherwise, I'm going to amplify stuff all the way to the goddamn UN. I'm embarrassed that you people think you're Americans. You run so much back to our operation. The shit machine is intoxicating. And COVID was released by the US government. And other companies who work with us. And anybody who says different is lying through their motherfucking teeth. I've worked in high level intelligence most longer than most of you have been fucking alive. And I was born into this shit. And I'm sad. Boy known as Joe, or JC, also created the person known as Kirk Kelly, the real one. And by the way, Senator, and all you other jackasses who try to infringe on my name, I do hold the copyright, trademarks, signature marks, and Kelly. And actually, under the laws, you're not supposed to use my franchise without express written consent. Peace out. And I expect to hear from you. Timely orders. If you can't handle it, why you run in the offices you run? I've done more electronic things than most of you could ever do in another lifetime. And that's not an exaggeration. I challenge you to rise up for peace. I can help you with it. I can help you. Or was the kid in Northern Michigan who on the party lines in the 60s blocked the party lines and dialed into ARPANET and the library of Congress sometimes with devices they put together with dollars and homegrown softwares, etc. From the Library of Congress where President Sanders, where President agreed with Mom. Yeah. But Mom always told me, and I went to private schools and public schools, I went to universities and in a lot of reading. I was in school as a kid in elementary and junior high and high school. I had already, by the time I got done with high school, I'd already been to Interlock. And toured throughout North America and Canada in singing groups, classically trained and rock trained bands and symphonies and performing groups and other spiritual groups. And had already been to D.C. and White House and National Trust. Of course, you know, for 122-year-old dead guy, who's also unfortunately incarcerated by LA institution, who would love to be able to look like a raving lunatic. That shit's all gonna get put on files, assholes. And all the fraudulent shit you put in all these years coming out. You see, it's on file at major institutions. I could go down a long list of PhDs that I know personally, I've consulted with, I've sat in those sessions with, and they would tell you, like,